What are we doing in this one here?
This was running 69 and 70, and it used to run 660s, 238 miles an hour.
Wow, look at this, huh?
Yeah.
What a thrill to see these old timers.
Oh, I love them, eh? I love them. Like
now, it's all changed over. They look like, what is those, bullhead sharks now with the engine in the back?
They don't look right.
They don't look like dragsters no more. No, this is a thrill.
It's like your old stuff. Great.
Yeah, just love it. Well, good to see you here and see you part of it.
Thanks for coming over.
Good. Thank you.
And I enjoyed your singing last night.
I got a big kick out of that. That was a fun project.
This is Guy Lombardo's boat called Tempo 7.
Yes.
Tempo 7, that was driven by a man named Danny Foster from Michigan. Guy Lombardo used to drive his own boats until he rolled it, and Decca Records wouldn't let him drive his boats anymore. Right. Every trophy that boat won, Danny Foster was the driver.
Hiya, Doug.
Next year, he's being inducted into the Walk of Fame in Richmond, Indiana.
Oh, that's terrific.
Where they first cut their first records, March the 10th, 1924, at the Jeanette Star Studios in Richmond, Indiana. They are inducting him into their Walk of Fame. This year in September, in Long Island, he's being inducted into the Walk of Fame there. He was already in the Walk of Fame in Freeport in 71. He has 3 stars in the Walk of Fame in Hollywood.
Yes, that I know, because I walked over that many times. When did he start racing boats? What year, do you think?
It's about 1939.
39.
Racing, but he owned boats before. I guess it was 46 when he tipped the thing over in the Detroit River and got hurt.
Yes, I remember that.
They said that's the end of the boat racing.
Yeah, Decca Records said
it's either the boat or the band.
Right.
So that was the end of it. That's when Danny Foster became involved.
Now, this is an Allison engine in this, right?
Yes, it's a V16.
Yeah.
It's out of a Mustang aircraft. That's my understanding. I've heard 14 different variations this morning of what aircraft it came out of.
Yeah.
But I'll stick with the Allison with the Mustang.
Yeah. Here we are, still traveling through the gateways of this beautiful concourse with Steve Plunkett. 100 acres of ponds and lakes and rivers and green grass and guys eating hot dogs and hamburgers. That's it. Look at those wild cars. There's that 442 Oldsmobile. That is terrific. Wow. They got some power on here. All these muscle cars. Oh, look at this Ford Victoria Fairlane. It's just gorgeous. Everything you can think of is here. There's not a car that I haven't seen yet that I can't dream of. Oh, look at that blue on that Chevy. How you doing there? Look at these. Oh, my golly, Moses. There's a hot-looking Mustang. What is this here? What is this here? What is that?
Chair.
Oh, that's that car seat. Show me a little bit about this wonderful car seat, car, plush. Boy, oh, boy, look at this. Oh, I'm in heaven. Oh, wait a minute. It's all steel. I thought it was... I thought it was made out of fiberglass. You use the English roller on this?
Yeah, I had to make one.
Oh, you had to make your roller like I did. I had to make my roller too. Yeah. Oh my golly! Look at this beautiful piece. No, I thought it was a 37 Ford, but no, the front end is a handmade front end with a billet grill. What do you call your luxury couch?
It's just an artistic sculpture of a car that just happens to be a couch.
Well, that's what he called it, an artistic sculpture of a car that he happens to vision and makes it into a car couch.
Yeah.